The difference between investing early and later shows the power of compound interest and why you should be taking advantage of it immediately, like right now. This channel is all about personal finance, so please consider hitting that subscribe button below if you want to learn more about money. Albert Einstein said this about compound interest. Compound interest is the greatest mathematical discovery of all time. Why would you not want to participate in the greatest mathematical discovery of all time? So how does compound interest work? Let's say you had a penny and every day for 30 days it doubled. So the first day you have one penny, the second day you have two pennies, the third day you have four pennies, and the fourth day you have eight pennies, which doesn't sound like a lot, right? Because compound interest is a very slow start. By the end of 30 days, you'd have $5.3 million. Obviously, there's no investment that's gonna double every single day, but that just shows the power of something compounding. But let's take a look at an investment that everyone can do, and that's the stock market, which on average has done just over 10% every year since its inception. Let's take $1,000. You invest it and you don't touch it, you don't add anything to it. At the end of 1 year, you have $1,100. You go into the second year with that $1,100. You would make 10% off of that, which is $110. Added to that is gonna be $1,210. You go into the third year with $1,210. And at the end of the year, it would equal $1,331. Again, we're still not adding anything. You take the $1,331 on the fourth year, gets another 10%, and you finish with $1,464. So even though the first year you only made $100, the fourth year you made $133, but we didn't add anything to it. That just shows you the power of something that is compounding. It's continuing to make more money. Not only is the initial $1,000 making money, but now the interest that you're gaining year over year is also making interest. It's interest making interest. That's compound interest. Albert Einstein also said compound interest is the eighth wonder of the world. He who understands it earns it. He who doesn't pays it. So there's two types of people. The person that understands compound interest builds wealth. The person that does not understand or does not try to understand it continues to stay broke. Come on now, hit the like button if you're learning something. One of my favorite sayings is, give a man a fish, you feed him for a day. Teach a man to fish, you feed him for a lifetime. Again, we see two different types of people here. Some of you guys need to stop buying fish and learn to be the fisherman. The broke person continues to pay for the fish instead of just investing in a fishing pole and learning how to fish. You have to put yourself on the other side of the equation here to build wealth, because you can do it. You just have to force yourself to do it and to start thinking differently. Start realizing that the more money you borrow, the more interest you're paying, the more you're penalizing yourself. In other words, stop buying the eggs and save up to buy the hen that will lay more eggs than you could have ever bought. When you save up money when you've been working and you put it away in the bank, $20,000, $30,000, what do you think the bank is doing with that money? They're using it as leverage to give out loans or to invest it themselves. This is where you have to put yourself on the other side of the equation. Instead of putting $20,000 in the bank and letting it sit there and then going and financing a $20,000 car, you're essentially giving the bank your own money and then taking it back with penalty in the form of interest. Let's compare investing in your 20s, 30s, 40s, and 50s. For every person, we're gonna invest $500 a month from that age until they retire at age 60. So for the 20-year-old, he does $500 a month and he finishes with $3.1 million. The 30-year-old does the same amount and he finishes with $1.1 million, so already less than half just starting in your 30s. The 40-year-old does $500 a month and finishes with $379,000. And the 50-year-old finishes with $102,000, not even enough to live off of. And take a look at the 40-year-old who finished with $379,000 versus the 20-year-old who finished with over $3 million. The 20-year-old's hen is laying eggs, is giving the 20-year-old eggs that are almost as much as the 40-year-old's hen. So in other words, that $3 million is gonna continue to produce $300,000 a year, which is what the 40-year-old has total. But a lot of people think the average person can't do this. So let's look at some common purchases, such as coffee, $5 a day, right? If you do that from age 25 to 60, if you invest the money instead, you would finish with $569,000. For a car payment, the average car payment this year was $445 a month. Instead, if you invested that, you'd finish with $1.6 million. So there you go, you're already a net worth millionaire. College tuition on average this year was $26,226. You pay that for 4 years. Let's say you paid that into an investment for four years and then you never touched it again. You'd finish with over $5.1 million. But yet the average amount a 60-year-old has saved today is $172,000. You gotta start thinking differently, guys. Hear me out though, it's not about not buying coffee or cars. It's about wanting to buy better coffee and better cars later in life. We have to get out of these ways of we earn money and then we spend the money. We earn the money, we spend the money, and your whole life is up, down, paycheck in, paycheck out. Instead, we want to get on a path that gradually increases over time. So it's not about making money, it's about building wealth. And we're paying for things we can afford along the way as long as the chart is still gradually going up. The point being, eventually you'll get to a point where now you have a hen that's laying eggs that can pay for whatever lifestyle that you want it to pay for. First, we want to make a plan to get there and goals to get there. And that starts with a budget, which I have a video on how to make a budget. You can click it above to watch that. Second, we want to plan to get there sooner. And we do that by doing things such as raising your income or making better investments. I'm tired of hearing that being wildly successful and building great amount of wealth is inaccessible for the lower and middle class. Because in about 10 minutes, you can open up an account that'll take advantage of the eighth wonder of the world, which is compound interest. And I also have a video on that, on which accounts to start with, and I'll link that above. Thanks for watching, guys. Please consider subscribing if you want to learn more about financial education. I put out new videos every week. And as always, you can check out timwolf.com for a one-on-one session. See you next week.